We have to be in super hyper growth mode. You guys are like, you know, telling me that you're making a few calls here and you're working your sphere and putting a few things on Facebook and stuff. And if you take that out of your mind, right, because you're focusing on that, and start focusing on, you need to do this so that you provide the best life for your family. So who cares about what you think and your feelings and, you know, if you're around other agents or if you need camaraderie? The universe doesn't care about that. Your family cares about you making calls, and that should be all that matters. That should be like a non-negotiable, I'm gonna do this no matter what. From now on, we're not thinking about we need camaraderie, we're thinking about we need to make calls because we need to provide the best life for our family right now. That's not gonna make your business grow, right? Unless you are like a 1% of 1% and you have somebody in your sphere who like is a developer or hooks you up with some kind of weird, like, you know, I'm gonna give you a million listings kind of thing, which is pretty rare. Unless you're in that boat, you're like just the traditional, like, average person's sphere is nothing that's gonna grow your business at all. That's just gonna like get your foot in the door into the market and like let you close one or two deals here and there. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
We have to be in super hyper growth mode. You guys are like, you know, telling me that you're making a few calls here and you're working your sphere and putting a few things on Facebook and stuff, and none of those things, like, I don't see the fire in your eyes, guys, where you're wanting to take your business to another level. And like, I want you guys to say, I gotta go and I'm gonna just crush whatever I have to make my business explode. And the only way to make your business explode is to talk to the most people. That's it. I don't care if you're doing it through cold call, for sale by owners, Facebook, Zillow. I really don't care the method. What do you do on Saturdays?
Volunteer work part of the day, and then I'm being lazy.
Okay. Can we scratch the volunteer work on Saturdays and keep that during the week?
We can.
Okay. Listen to me. Keep your Saturdays open. I want you to call from sun up to sundown every Saturday.
Okay.
I mean, listen, I'm just telling you this, and you can tell me you're going to do it. You know, you tell me you're going to do it means nothing to me. I only go by what people do. You know what I mean? And I want to see the fire in your eyes. You're like, you know what? Ricky's right. I just need to talk to more people. So what am I going to do? I'm going to talk to more people. I'm not going to make an excuse that I need to be around other people. I'm not going to make an excuse that I have a 9-to-5 or 8-to-5 job through the week. If all I have is Saturdays, I'm going to take advantage of every second. All right. So I'm the expired listing. Are you doing old expireds, new expireds?
Let's do new expireds.
Okay, new expireds. Okay, I'm a brand new expired. I just expired yesterday. All right. Okay. So ring, ring, ring. Hello?
Hi, Mr. Carruth?
Yep.
Hi, Mr. Carruth. This is Lisa Ponder with ERA King. How are you today?
Doing just fine.
Oh, it's good. Me too. I'm just enjoying the good weather outside. Isn't it gorgeous today?
It sure is. Hey, listen, here's one of your problems, okay? You ready for this?
Mm-hmm.
You're talking too slow.
Okay.
You gotta pick it up just a tad. And that difference in your speed, I'm telling you, is gonna get them engaged, because the way that you're talking to me now makes me wanna be like, come on, like what is the deal? Like, I'm already getting into the mindset of, oh my gosh, this phone call is gonna be like 3 hours long. How do I get out of this?
Okay.
Right? You've got to pick it up just a little bit. Not to where you're talking fast. I'm just saying pick it up a little bit. It's like, hey, Mr. Carruth.
Okay.
They're like, hey, Mr. Carruth, you know, it's so-and-so with whatever real estate company. How you doing? You know, you're talking slow and it's dragging it out, you know, and listen, guys, with my scripts, okay, this is like deep, okay? Like, the scripts is not like words on a piece of paper. This is real stuff. This is psychology of prospecting, okay? There's three questions in the beginning of this script, okay? It's by design, and it's designed to collect data from the prospect so I can see which way I need to go with this call and how quick I need to speak, the tone, how I need to make this thing flow and keep them engaged, all right? Understand that everything in the script is there for a reason. See, this is what I'm talking about. You didn't really listen to me when I'm talking to Lisa. Guys, please listen to me, okay? Everybody listening right now, please listen to me and incorporate this into your script. Tell them that, you know, who you are, the company, right here in Long Island. What's so hard about this, guys? Do you guys understand the power of telling people that you're in their local market? When Russell says eXp Realty, that could mean he's in Arizona, California, Seattle, Dallas. I don't know where he's at. I'm already throwing up red flags because I don't know this guy's in my local market. If I knew he was in my local market from the moment that the call started, then it's like instant credibility. Too much, it doesn't flow. It's very choppy. It's all over the place. There's no conformity. We're not flowing. We're not connecting. We're not engaging. But you are trying, and that's what I loved about it. I did feel like you were trying to like get to me. Here, let's try this, right? Number one, you didn't even know, you don't even know who I am because you just said, hey, this is so-and-so with whatever real estate. And you didn't really tell, and you really didn't tell me where you're at, you know? Like, I'd love for you to say, hey, is this Mr. Carruth? Hey, Mr. Carruth, this is so-and-so at whatever real estate company right here in Chicago or whatever, right? It's like I'm right here in your backyard, just so you know. I'm right here with you. We are in this thing together. That's what that tells them when you say something about where you're at compared to where they are, right? And then when I say I'm washing dishes and you hear dishes in the background, that's a dead giveaway not to talk about the weather or do anything weird. Let's get on with it because, you know, my hands are wet and I'm washing dishes. See, here's a perfect example, guys. You don't use that every time sometimes. And it's really rare that you don't use it. I don't want you to not use it because you're feeling like they're in a hurry. That's when you do use it, because when they're in a hurry and you can throw that in there, it really softens them up. It really softens them up. You need to use it in the moments like that. But then there are moments that you don't use it, all right? And then listen, let's use this as a script instead of what you did as far as like, why do you think it didn't sell? Nah, let's not go there. Listen, here, go with this. You ready? It's like, hey, listen, man, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I saw your house was for sale, you know, earlier this year or whatever. Whatever happened with that? All because they said, I'm not selling my house. I'm like, good, listen, I'm not here to try to get you to sell your house. That's not what I'm doing here. I'm here to let you know something sold and see if there's something I can do to help you. They're like, no. I'm like, cool, is there an agent you would work with? You know, are you looking to possibly do something in the future? You know, well, da-da-da-da-da, bam. A lot of you guys would have just aborted. Let's be open-minded to all the opportunities that a human in our market could offer us as a real estate agent, guys. Looking for only my listing and nothing else.
All right. Pretend it not to be, right? Okay, here we go.
Ring, ring, ring. I don't know if he's going to pick up. Ring, ring, ring. Hello?
Yeah, hey, bud. This is Zach Rossica with eXp Realty down here on 38. How you doing today?
I'm good, but this ain't Bud. Who you looking for, Bud? Bud who?
Okay, no, I'm looking for James.
Yeah, this is James. That's weird. Bud, James, I don't know.
Hey, James. Yeah, hey, James. This is Zach Rosk. I'm with eXp down here on 38. I saw your property there on Fort Panic popped off the market about 6 months ago. And I was just calling to see whatever happened with that.
Well, Zach, you can look on MLS and tell what happened to it. It didn't sell.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Well, could be multiple reasons why it didn't sell, but you know, I stay busy here. I got plenty of buyers, but you know, I'd love the opportunity to potentially stay in touch should you ever need anything in the future. Would that be all right?
I think it's pretty good. I think right there, instead of going in that direction, I think you should have dug deeper with, well, what are you looking to do with it?
Gotcha.
You know, because I'm like, oh, it didn't sell. And then you went towards, well, I'd love to work with you in the future, whatever. But really, you didn't really find out if I'm still even interested in selling.
Right.
See, you should have dug a little deeper there and said, well, cool. I do see it didn't sell. That's what I'm calling. It expired. So kind of like, yeah, I'm not a dummy. I did see that, sir. And if at that moment you would have went a little deeper and said, I got you. Yeah, see, it didn't sell. Number one, like I said, you know, why do you think it didn't sell? And, you know, would you still be interested in selling?